I'm Tara Douglas. I want to send a great big thank you from the shelter out to our Saturday dog walkers. We were talking about that over the weekend. We have been walking dogs there since September of 2022, and it's very rare that we ever have a weekend we don't get every dog out of its kennel. So we appreciate all the community support. We appreciate all those people that show up every Saturday to make sure those dogs get some much needed time outside of their kennels. But it also gives us a lot of wonderful information about the dog. So the more people that we have come, the more pictures we have, the more videos we have, and we're able to tell you more about them so that the rescues and the adopters can know exactly what kind of personality we have. And our pet of the week this week is one of those dogs. This is Hans. And he has actually been at the shelter since November of 2022, so we really need to find him a home. Hans is close to 2 years old, and he is just very sweet. He's great on walks, he's very active. Now Hans is a little bit of a special case because he does have a cough, and so he has been treated, he has been to the vet, he's cleared, everything is healthy about him, but when he gets really excited, if he starts running, if he pulls on his leash, he does cough some, so we assume he's probably gonna have that chronic cough his whole life, but he is healthy, and he doesn't have any problems with that cough. So if you are interested in adopting this very sweet dog, please come out and join us on Saturday. You can walk him, you can pet him. Please share this information because we are desperately trying to find Hans a home. And if you come out, one other thing, if you want to come out and walk the dogs, that's great. Today, we always need the dog walkers, but if you're not interested in walking, you just want to pet a dog, you can come out. We have plenty of dogs that need some socialization. We have plenty of younger puppies that have had all their shots, and so they are able to get out and about, and we've got a play yard. You can get out there and play with some of the young dogs there and help us interact with them. So that's every Saturday from 11 to 1. Now, I'm very excited to get to our special guests today. We have Allie Price and Ellie Bass here. So ladies, thank you so much for coming on the show. Well, I appreciate you coming on here. So where do you guys go to school?
Knollwood Christian School.
Knollwood.
Okay, so you're at Knollwood, and Allie, what grade are you in?
Fourth.
Fourth. And Ellie, what grade are you in?
I can't remember.
So you're gonna be starting kindergarten next year, right? So you're in K-4?
Mm-hmm.
Are you excited to start kindergarten? Yeah. And Allie, what is your favorite subject?
Science.
Science, well that's a great thing to do. That's a wonderful, wonderful subject to have that you love. Okay, so let's talk about what's going on at Knollwood right now. So Allie, you play tennis.
Yes.
Good, are you enjoying it? And how long have you been playing?
I've been playing.
Has it been this year, a little bit before this year?
It's been like last semester. We just stopped for a little while.
Okay.
But we're starting back next Tuesday.
Well, good, we should have some good weather for you to do that. And Miss Ellie, you're a gymnast, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're having your first ribbon meet coming up soon?
Uh-huh.
Are you excited about it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, good. Well, that's great. And you've got a fundraiser that's happening at Knollwood right now,
mm-hmm.
correct? Selling ferns. So we've got a fern sale at Knollwood. They're $18 each, correct? And there are three different types of ferns, so make sure that you contact Knollwood. You can also contact these ladies' mom, Mackenzie Price. She can help you figure out what kind of ferns and pay for them, and that is a fundraiser that's coming up at Knollwood. So now let's get to dogs and cats. So I've got some pictures up right now. So there's a picture of three kitties. So tell me about your kitties.
Yeah. That's Rissy and that's Mott. That is Mau Mau.
And Socks.
And Socks. Okay, so who's the best kitty out of the three of them?
Mau Mau.
Okay.
Socks doesn't let us hold him.
Socks won't let you hold him at all? Now, Ellie, do you like puppies or kitties better?
I like kitties.
So tell me why you like kitties the best.
Because they're super calm.
So our kitties at our house are not so calm. They purr. That is nice to be around a kitty that purrs, isn't it? And so they're not as loud as dogs, are they?
Mm-mm.
Mm-mm. But you've got dogs too, correct? There's your dogs.
Mm-hmm.
So what are your dogs' names?
Daisy, Buddy, and Solly.
Okay.
Daisy.
Now who's the sweetest out of the dogs?
Daisy.
Which one is Daisy?
The biggest one.
The big one. I bet they're all sweet.
Mm-hmm, they are.
They are.
Buddy and Solly are the only ones can bite.
Because
they can't bite.
So tell me more about the dogs. Are they loud?
Yeah.
Yeah. So now the two of you went to the shelter, correct? Got to go this week?
And there was a lot of dogs, and they were so loud. If you go in there, they will be loud.
They are. Those dogs are excited when they see somebody come to the shelter, and they all start barking, don't they?
Uh-huh.
Now, did you get to go in the kitty room also?
Uh-huh.
The kitty room was quiet, right?
Uh-huh. And one kitty was so nice. You can go to her purr, and if you buy her, her's going to be super sweet to you, mm-hmm. and her, you will love on her forever.
That's the truth, isn't it? So mm-hmm. so what would you say, what would both of you say to the community about the dogs and cats we have at the shelter?
I'm going to say all of them are nice, but dogs are rough.
They're loud?
Uh-huh.
Yes, they are loud. But they all need homes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So don't you think it'd be great for people to go out to the shelter and meet the dogs and cats and find some homes for them?
Yes. Okay. Because there's a lot of cats. The homes didn't wanted them, and another. So a people pick them up and take them to the animal shelter. Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of cats out and about, and they can go to the animal shelter and have an opportunity to find a home, right?
Yeah, another home.
Mm-hmm. So Allie, tell me about the cat that your family was able to adopt for someone in your family.
Last night, mm-hmm. that kitty was so nice.
So nice? Is that the kitty that you took
uh-huh.
for your uncle?
Here's a snug cat, mm-hmm. her wolf. Her likes to come out when it's me around.
Mm-hmm.
And here's my best friend.
Yeah. Our kitties and puppies can be our best friends,
and
can't
her,
they?
And her likes me.
Well, that's good. And you like her too?
Uh-huh.
Absolutely. Now, you have other animals, too. I got a picture up here of a chicken.
Mm-hmm, so, and that's Grace.
That's Grace? Uh-huh. So how many chickens do y'all have?
10.
You have 10 chickens?
And one of them died.
Okay.
From moose.
Okay,
moose
that happens.
Is a big dog.
Okay.
And he kills animals.
Okay. So tell me about Grace, because Grace, you're holding there in the picture. Grace is the only chicken you have that lets you pick her up, right?
Uh-huh, and Grace chased me before, and he can pick very hard and it can lead.
So a chicken can peck you hard?
Mm-hmm.
Now, did this chicken peck you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
She's nice to me.
Okay.
I let her, she lets me pick her up, but.
Now, do you pick up any of the other chickens, or is it only Grace?
I pick up some of them, but not a lot.
Okay.
There's a speckled chicken. She's gray and has, like, black spots. I took grass and held it in my hand and then put it down,
mm-hmm.
and then I just grabbed her from.
So you were able to pick up one other one, but not as easily as Grace.
That was new.
Grace wasn't that easy, but she was easier.
So tell me a little bit about what you have to do to take care of chickens, Allie.
Well, you have to, you need either a coop so mm-hmm. and boxes so they can lay their eggs.
Okay.
In there.
Now, do you know how to get eggs from the chickens? Do you go out and do that for your parents?
Yes.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm. They just started laying their eggs again.
Okay.
But so you'll need to put some shavings in the chicken coop and then have a little area so they can eat the grass and where you can go inside and feed them and water them.
Okay. Well, that's you are a chicken expert. You know exactly what to do with chickens. I don't have any chickens, so I'll have to come and see if I can pick up Grace sometime and meet your chickens. What do your dogs and cats think about the chickens?
So moose can kill our chickens.
Okay, so you have to be careful.
They, mm-hmm. and they And they weigh babies.
Okay.
This time.
Okay.
Here.
Yeah.
And these chickens, my chickens don't love me so much.
Okay. Sometimes chickens don't.
If I look them in the eye, they'll start chasing me around.
Okay. And you don't like to be chased by chickens? No. That's why you like kitties.
So if you pick a chicken up and put it down, it's going to try to chase you.
Okay. So it will chase you.
Or pick you.
Mm-hmm. Not too long ago when it was like storming, raining, the chicken coop door got flung open.
Oh no.
And so the chickens got out and me and Mackenzie were chasing them. And we got one in, but the two other ones wouldn't go in.
Oh no. And so you're out in the storm trying to get chickens back in the coop?
Uh-huh, but we got them all in.
Good. Well, that's perfect. Well, I appreciate the two of you coming on the show and showing us your kitties and puppies and chicken.
We've been taking our animals for so long and we've been keeping them safe, but one of our chickens died.
Yeah, sometimes that happens, but you are doing such a good job with all your kitties and puppies and such a good job with your chickens, and just make sure they don't chase you too much.
Okay.
And then let's encourage people to come out to the shelter, just like the two of you did, because you were able to take some supplies and some food. Mm-hmm. And the shelter loves donations, and we appreciate the two of you for going out there with your family to take some supplies to them and meeting some of the kitties and puppies. So come on out some Saturday and walk dogs with us. And then let's get the community out there and to meet all the puppies and kitties. So we need to find homes for all of them, right? Mm-hmm. So they can have a home just like the two of you have provided for your kitties and puppies. But we never have chickens at the shelter. So don't think you're going to go to the shelter and get chased by a chicken, because you're not. It'd be a really weird day if a chicken chased you at the shelter.
They are very fast.
They are. Yeah, you got to be super fast. You can become a really good runner if you have a chicken chasing you, though.
I am.
That's good.
I can run very fast.
Good. Well, then you need that if you go out there and take care of the chickens. All right, ladies. Well, thank you for coming on the show. We'll have you on sometime for to tell us more about your dogs and cats and chickens. Or if you get any other creatures, you can tell us about them. And make sure that you come out this Saturday to walk dogs and meet Hans. Don't forget that Hans is available for adoption, and he is ready to go. He's got all of his shots. He's heartworm negative, and again, he's one of the sweetest dogs. And we hope to see everybody out at the shelter on Saturday from 11 to 1. We'll have more Daybreak after these messages.